Let's go to Eric. Eric, you're on the air.
Hi. I'm calling because a couple weeks ago you referred to Kelly Clarkson as an unattractive, ugly white girl. Well, I don't think so. She is anything but ugly and unattractive.
Are Eric, you related to her?
No, I'm not.
Eric, how old are you?
27.
What's wrong with you? There's something wrong, right?
Well, I'm a disabled person.
Yeah, okay.
You're a guy?
Yes.
Oh.
I'm only 3'5", 3'6".
We got to get you down here. You're in love with Kelly Clarkson of American Idol?
Yep.
Maybe we can hook you two kids up.
If I can get her to come in here, maybe I can hook you up with her.
Wouldn't mind that, is for sure.
What? 3'5"? What are you, a midget?
Yeah.
And what, are you ill or something?
No. It's just, it's 5 o'clock in the morning here.
Are you shorter than Mini-Me?
No, I think he's around the 2-foot mark.
Wow.
Right.
I'm always amazed at how little Mini-Me is.
Yeah.
If Mini-Me's 2 foot, you're 3'5"?
3'5".
You tower over him.
Yeah.
Somewhere in between that.
You work in a circus or on a show or something?
No. I'd like to get into show business, into acting, and into singing and stuff like that.
What do you do right now?
Actually, nothing. I'm living off SSI.
Yeah, well, Kelly Clarkson, I actually said was the best one to win because she had the best voice, but she's got to lose about 15 pounds. They got to dress her better. She got big hips. The hairdo they gave her was very New Jersey with the black and white skunk stripes. She needs some work, yeah.
Well, from what she said to Bob Gowen on Entertainment Tonight, like the day after she won, she said that her natural hair color, I don't know if she was kidding, but she said her natural hair color was as blonde as Reese Witherspoon.
I don't know about that, but whatever they dyed it, it looks bad, and you got to go with me on that. I mean, it's not a good color. It's not human. There's no human hair that looks like that with like stripes. She's got like pinstripes. She got racing stripes all over her head, equidistant from one another. Whoever did that definitely, you know, was goofing on her. And you think she's hot, because how picky can you be? You're sitting in the room. When's the last time you got laid?
Never.
Exactly.
Oh, how old did he say you were?
20. How old are you?
27.
Wow.
This guy's never gotten laid. That's why you're pining away for her.
Did you go out and buy her a single?
Yeah.
Oh, jeez.
All you got to do, my friend, is get a little stank on your hang low.
You'll forget all about her.
Yeah, you'll forget all about Kelly Clarkson.
Yeah.
No.
Oh, yeah. You got pictures of her hanging on your wall?
No, but on my computer I have some photos.
What do you got?
This one's off various websites that, you know, fans have made for her.
Kelly Clarkson website?
When you're whacking it, do you think about Kelly Clarkson?
No.
Tell the truth.
No.
Have you
then
ever?
Who do you think about?
And don't tell me you're not whacking it.
How do I answer that?
Yeah, with the truth. You never think of Kelly Clarkson when you're whacking it?
No.
You never imagine, like, you run into her somewhere and she's like, you know, I was really into that midget on Wizard of Oz. You really turned me on. And blah, 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 blah. One thing leads to another. Before you know it, you're banging her.
No.
I don't believe you. See, you're not being straight with me.
Yeah, I am.
Who do you whack it to, then? Pam Anderson?
No, just other celebrity females.
Give me your top three. Whack material.
Oh, let's see. Well, one off Seventh Heaven, Beverly Mitchell.
Beverly Mitchell from Seventh Heaven. That's the top girl to whack it to?
Well, one of them.
No little people?
No.
What about Gary Coleman?
Oh, please.
No, don't go that way.
There you go.
Good for you.
All right, the chick from Seventh Heaven. Who else?
Let's see, who else? Britney.
Britney Spears? What's the scenario?
I don't know.
Like, how do you make believe you meet her? Like, what do you do? Like, you're at a party or something?
Yeah, out somewhere.
And you meet her, and then what happens? You sneak a ladder into her bedroom?
No.
What do you do?
Climb up to her ass.
Tell me what happens.
I don't really remember.
How do you start, like, getting her in a room and kissing her? There's got to be, oh, when guys do it, there's got to be some sort of thread of a story.
Not anything I could think of.
You're
just not coming clean with us.
Yeah. Who's your third favorite to whack it to? Britney Spears, the chick from Seventh Heaven. Who you got in there? Leslie Stahl? Who else? You got to get somebody who's realistic.
Realistic.
You're not going to get Britney Spears. You're not going to get the chick on Seventh Heaven.
So Leslie Stahl's a good bet?
Leslie Stahl, you could probably bang. I'm just trying to help the guy.
Kelly Clarkson is probably a good one.
You probably could get her.
You need a chick you could sneak up on.
See, I wonder if I was a midget, would I fantasize about other midgets?
No.
Well, I got to get realistic.
Yeah, but...
Really? You have to be realistic?
Yeah, because you're not going to bang full-size chicks. There's very few midgets can pull that off. Come on, this kid doesn't have a rap.
Before you ever had sex with anybody, you were doing it to the girls of Gilligan's Island.
Yeah, that's true. But I was also more times than not doing it to chicks in my school or chicks
really?
In college. Yeah, chicks I met during the day.
All right, I did not know that. Mm.
But this kid's got a hard-on for Kelly Clarkson. He's not going to get her.
Well, I'm so happy that that stupid song has not become a huge hit.
Yeah, thank God this country isn't buying into that. It's a bad song.
Being obsessed with Kelly Clarkson is just going to lead to a horrible spiral into depression.
What, you got the single?
Yeah.
Sing it for me.
I don't have it memorized.
You know the words.
You know the chorus, at least.
How many times have you listened to it?
A couple. I can't.
Come on.
I can't sing it.
Come on, Eric.
I can't.
Eric the Midget, he wants Kelly Clarkson.
For starters, it's not my singing style.
Oh, what do you sing?
Country. But
country.
Sing me a country song. I got to hear you sing.
I'm bad a cappella. Trust me.
Oh, dear. Come on.
Something tells me you're not Garth Brooks with instruments.
Well, anyway, you've defended Kelly Clarkson's honor. She does need a little work, you know, if she's going to be in show business. You're right, though. She's an attractive girl. She's not unattractive. I'll go along with you there.
She's cute.
She's a cute girl.
Yeah.
All right, brother.
Well, also wanted to know, did Benji ever go out with Anna Nicole?
Benji, no, he got stood up.
He struck out.
As usual, he went over to a hotel where she agreed to go out with him. She didn't show up for like an hour, and then he left.
Mm.
She wouldn't even meet with him. She was right upstairs.
Yeah.
All right, thanks.
Bye.
All right, Eric. It's Eric the Midget. Hey, Eric.
Huh?
I'm going to give you $500.
Okay, yeah. So I give you my address.
Hold on. You could be a little more excited about it.
I'm excited. Thank you.
This won't mess up your benefits, will it?
Yeah, really.
Yeah, don't declare this.
We don't want to kick you up into a higher bracket.
All right, thanks. All right. Enough with that guy.
Wow.
He was depressing me.
Depressed. Little person.
Yeah. I'm a little person, but I want Kelly Clarkson. People say I'm small, but I have a big heart. Yeah, Tony, you're on the air.
Hey, Howard.
Midget should always be cheerful.
Yeah, I gotta try harder.
You know, you can't get into show business being a miserable midget.
Hello, I'm your miserable midget.
I'm a miserable midget. Hire me. Okay, you're on the air. Go ahead, Eric.
Hey, Howard. I called you last week, last Thursday, when I was talking to you about Kelly.
Oh, that's right. You're the Kelly Clarkson fan.
Yeah.
You're the midget, right?
Well, I would prefer not to be called that. A little person or vertically challenged is better.
Yeah, I remember you. You were a wise guy.
Well, I have a problem with something you said yesterday.
All right, go ahead.
You said that you cannot stand Kelly Clarkson's personality.
That's true.
Well, to me, he has a much better personality than anyone of your staff, including you.
Well, now you've put me in my place, haven't you?
Oh, glad you straightened us out.
See,
that is true, by the way.
He has the best personality of anyone.
I told you.
Now, this guy is totally in love with her. She just showed up.
I told you, you, first of all, I know, I feel bad for your midget and everything, and I know, you know, aren't you like a sick midget?
No, I'm disabled.
Yeah, you're disabled. I feel bad for you and everything, but I told you, you're wasting your time.
Kelly wouldn't look in your direction.
Yeah, she's not the type that would go out with a sick midget. I'm telling you, I can pick him out.
Somebody here would do that before she would.
You're sitting at home fantasizing about Kelly Clarkson from American Idol. I don't think she's going to give you the time of day. You got to get some little slut who's into some weird freaky midget stuff. You got to put yourself in that direction.
Yeah, I'm telling you, if you camped out to see Kelly at a concert and she walked by, she wouldn't even glance at you.
Yeah. Well, who is she?
Well, we'll see on November the 16th when they come to the Sacramento Arena.
You'll be there?
Yeah.
And what do you think's going to happen? She's going to, like, see you in your wheelchair and pick you out and bring your, you know, your midget ass on stage?
No.
Only Howard does things like that.
I'll do that. If you want to get on stage, dude, I guarantee you, I'll rush you right up there. You doing that in Sacramento? I should fly my ass out there, go with you, and we'll just barge our way in, and I'll get you introduced to that bitch.
But it's not going to turn into romance.
Yeah. But once again, man, I was giving you some solid advice. I think you have to lower your sights. Aren't you the dude with, like, the 50 posters of her on your wall?
No, I don't have any of her on my wall.
Who's on your wall?
Like, baseball stuff.
Baseball?
Yes.
That doesn't get girls either.
Yeah, if you get Kelly Clarkson up to your room, take down that baseball stuff off your wall.
Take down the poster of Felix Mian and put up somebody from...
You know? You hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You ought to get some, like, freaky stuff going on, like in your room, like weird stuff. Play the weird thing. Like, get some weird fetus stuff. Spread it around there. Yeah, or satanic posters.
Yeah, I think heavy metal. Go that way.
Yeah, go that way. Get into some freaky kind of stuff. You're too goody two-shoes. Look, you got to look at life realistically. You're a midget, right?
And are you in a wheelchair?
Yeah.
Put up a few Ozzy posters.
I like the show, but I don't like his music.
Yeah. Isn't there any other midget chicks you could go after?
No.
Do you ever go to those conventions?
No.
We'll go to like a burn center. That's where I used to go in high school. I was a total loser. So I
pick up a burn chick?
I go to burn centers. Suddenly I'm a stud. You always got to play the angle. You get one that's just burned on her back. And you get her. Wasn't your fantasy to bang Britney Spears?
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember you.
That's
what I'm saying. You're wasting your time with her. She's into pretty boys. You got to go to a burn center. You got a burn center where you live?
Not that I know of.
I'm sure there's one around.
I know every burn center in New York.
But he's in Sacramento.
Let me tell you something. When I was in high school, I couldn't get laid. I used to go to the Roosevelt Retarded Center, the CP Center. I go looking for chicks there.
Yeah,
I'd get
an idea.
I get the highly functional ones.
They need sex, too.
Right.
You know?
You hear what I'm doing? I'm giving you solid advice.
You can find one who can push your wheelchair.
Hell yeah. You should push more than your wheelchair, brother. You hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Don't waste your time with Kelly Clarkson and, you know, Britney Spears.
Britney Spears, come on.
Britney Spears is for homos. You're a real man.
I don't know, though. Kelly Clarkson?
Kelly Clarkson.
What kind of man is it?
Yeah, what kind of man are you?
What kind of midget are you?
You hear what I'm saying to you?
Yeah.
All right, where are you going today to meet chicks?
Nowhere.
You're going to the burn center.
That's not the right attitude.
I'm coming down here, and I'm going with you. Well, he doesn't listen to me, this kid. You want a prize?
Yeah.
Oh, you gave me $500 last week.
I'll give you another $500.
Yeah, I mean, do you still have the first $5?
I haven't gotten here yet.
All right, we're going to send another one.
I'm going to send you another $500, and get one of these burn victim girls, take her out to dinner.
Now he's got money. He should be able to get a girl.
Or go down to a CP center.
I'm thinking about doing that.
I'm going to give you $500, too. You could use it.
Yeah, I could.
Captain James.
I could use the burn center, too.
Also,
Artie Lang got laid in Vegas for
$500. Yeah, you know how I got laid before show business? Lowering my standards to unbelievable levels.
Yeah.
That's how you do it.
Everybody does it. You should see the pigs I've been with.
There's no shame in it.
Shame? I feel like $1 million. I mean, the shame if people see you going into a room.
That's right.
I do it daily.
Yeah, I mean, really. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah. Also, last week, you, when I was on hold, you mentioned something about you were wondering why Rosie's hand was wrapped again. Turns out she had her final surgery.
Now, let me tell you something. Forget about Rosie O'Donnell, but it makes a good point. Why don't you hang out by Weight Watchers? There's tons of fat chicks.
Yeah, I kind of relate to that because in the last year, since April of last year, I've had hand surgery myself and have had to have 3 surgeries.
Listen, stop whining.
The first one almost killed me, by the way.
Yeah,
that's unbecoming.
Yeah, don't talk to chicks like that. Don't talk about your medical problems. We just got to get a little stink on your hang low, and we'll work you up.
Yeah.
We got to get you over to Overeaters Anonymous.
Let's hear you say, hey, baby, what's up?
Yeah, say, hey, baby, what's up?
No.
Come on. You're not thinking like a winner. I'm sending you all this money so you can get chicks. You're sitting in your room. You're pining away for American Idol and Britney Spears. Forget about those broads. They'll fleece you anyway. That Kelly Clarkson's a little gold digger.
She'll have that $1,000 in no time.
I want you to spend this $1,000 on some of these burn victims and overweight chicks.
Why would a person that won $1 million herself have to be a gold digger?
It's
never enough. It's endless. You ever date a chick over 70?
No, would not want to.
Oh, you see, this kid's never going to get laid. I can't help him.
Come on, let's hear you come. We got to help him with his rap, because he doesn't have any rap.
And you know how fast Kelly Clarkson's going to turn $1 million into an RV?
And by the way, here's your rap. Honey, you want a little stinky midget love? That's what you say to them. You get one of these freaks to go along with it.
What's your look? How do you dress?
This is what you say to chicks. Hey, what are you wearing? Astronaut pants? Because your ass is out of this world. Try that. Say that. Say it.
Say it.
Do I have to?
Yes.
What are you wearing? Astronaut pants? Because your ass is out of this world.
Look at Robin taking his shirt off. Dude, if you go down to one of these CP centers and you say that, I guarantee you'll get laid. I've done it. I'm not too proud.
And how should he dress? Because I bet you his looks all messy.
I don't think it matters.
What kind of hair you got?
You got hair?
Yeah, short hair.
Yeah, that's good.
Wear a hat.
You got a big head and a small body?
No.
What do you got?
Normal-sized head.
You know, like everything in proportion?
Pretty much.
What about your wiener? You got something down there?
Do I really have to go there with you?
Yes, you do. Yes.
Yes.
You do have something down there?
Yes.
You got a nice set of balls? No, I'm trying to talk man to man. This guy, no one's talking to him. Where's your dad? Does he talk to you?
Yeah.
Does he teach you how to get girls?
No, I don't really.
Let me tell you something, son. I'm talking as a father. I'm a father myself. You're going to get laid. You got to set your sights a lot lower. Knock off this nonsense with these TV chicks. Rip down those baseball posters.
Put up some cars or something.
I know tons of midgets getting laid.
with full-size women. But they got a whole rap going, and there's, I guarantee you, no baseball posters in their room.
I'm really into sports.
Well,
yeah.
First of all, those posters make you look bad. You're in a wheelchair.
I know.
These chicks come in, they start pining away for a guy who can play baseball.
There's no midgets on the Dodgers.
Right. I mean, put up posters of homeless women.
He's cracking himself up.
It ain't. Hey, here's another good line. Are those astronaut pants you're wearing? Hey, did you ever bang a midget?
Try this. I want to suck on your cooch until your head caves in.
Can I make out with your knee?
Let me tell you something. You've got to play up all of your advantages.
Now, what would they be?
Well, tell chicks you'll get them a good parking spot. I like you. And if you want me to, I don't know if I should make this promise. I was thinking of flying down there and going to the Kelly Clarkson concert
really?
And introducing him. But he'll see what she is. He'll see what...
Forget it. At least he has a fantasy right now.
Yeah. I'm telling you, this guy can get laid. All he needs is an image. And he's got to set his sight on the right chicks.
Could be worse.
If you were in New York, I'd take it right over to the Burn Center.
Right.
Well, the CP Center.
Oh, they got a lot of centers here.
Hell yeah. You got a center for everything.
He could be at a different center every day.
To me, those are just potential places to meet chicks when things are going rough. I like you. That's why I help you.
Of course, you're not going to take any of this advice, are you?
You're not. I know you. You always reject my advice.
Hey, look, man, before I was on the Stern Show and I was just gross and disgusting, you know how I had sex? I banged midgets.
All right, I'm going to give you another $500, but don't squander it on Kelly Clarkson stuff, okay? Just promise me.
I have bills to pay off.
All right, good. $500 courtesy of That 70 Show. Now, on all week long, go to that70show.com or check your local listings for the time and channel, all right? And also, hey, by the way, you'll like this. You're also qualified to win a trip to the set of That 70s Show in Hollywood to appear on the show.
Oh, I hope he wins.
If you win, you'll get a free trip to California.
Well, he's in California.
I'm in California.
Oh. Well, that's your luck, isn't it?
I know, that's the way his luck is.
But listen, you'll be on That 70s Show. You get your break in show business. Next thing you know, Kelly Clarkson sees you. Next thing you know, Hef sees you. You'll be swimming in the pool with Mini-Me.
How about that? All midgets in the pool.
All right.
Yes, thank you.
All right. If you ever need help, you call me back.
I emailed you last week.
Oh, okay. Well, my email is slow here.
It hasn't gotten to you?
It hasn't gotten me yet. They haven't delivered it yet. All right, thank you.
Uh-huh.
Right. He's a good guy.
Easy.
I like that guy. Eric, you're on the air. Oh, this is Eric the Midget, everybody. You know Eric the Midget. Eric?
He can't reach the mic.
Is this the guy who can barely hear?
I can hear.
Yeah, we can't hear you, dude.
Is this better?
No.
No. I'm lowering everyone's mic, but... What's up?
Oh, not much. I was just calling in because...
Britney Spears visit you yet?
Yeah.
No.
This dude's a midget. He's in a wheelchair. His whole life's like screwball stuff. And then he's got hanging on his walls Britney Spears... pictures.
And he's in love with the American Idol chick.
Yeah. And he's in love with Kelly Clarkson.
Really?
And I was like, dude, you got to go to like a burn victims unit and date chicks.
Yeah, happy hour at the Shriner Center.
Yeah. You could get laid. Because he wants to get laid, right?
Yeah.
Eric wants to get laid. I said, you could get laid, but Britney Spears isn't going to bang you, and neither is Kelly Clarkson.
Really?
I said, give that up.
Yeah.
And I said, beside, if you ever do get a broad up there, no girl's going to go for you if you got a Britney Spears poster on your wall. You're going to think you're a douche.
I got one. I got all my faculty.
You know what I'm saying, Eric?
Yeah. I call in because the last couple times I called, I forgot to mention something about two of the other American Idols.
Can you talk louder? Because I don't want to miss this.
Sure. Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
World of difference.
Yeah.
This makes absolutely no difference when he says, can you hear me now?
He's
in a
not
bubble?
Doing anything different.
Could you talk taller?
Yeah.
Talk as loud as you can.
All right.
Oh, there you go.
Yell.
The thing, what I was going to say was, on Entertainment Tonight a couple weeks ago, they interviewed Nikki McKibben, who, if I remember correctly, was one of your favorites.
This guy's obsessed. I try to get him a different rap, because he was, you know, I was trying to tell him how to get laid. You know, and I know, because I'm an ugly dude who managed to get laid a lot. And so I got tips. You know, any good-looking guy can tell you how to get laid. You walk into a bar and chicks want you.
No, they can't tell you, because they don't know how it's happening. It just happens all the time.
I'm telling the guy, hey, listen, give up the American Idol obsession. This guy, he's living a life where he's fantasizing about all the kids on American Idol. But go ahead. All right, so my favorite, Nikki McKibben.
Two summers ago, she...
Dude, I've moved on from Nikki McKibben. I don't even remember Nikki McKibben. It was American Idol was fun. You're still living it. That's all I'm saying.
Well, I meant to tell you this the last couple times I talked to you, but I forgot.
All right, go ahead.
She told the interviewer that two summers ago she was a topless dancer at a Texas club.
Right, I know that.
Oh, you did? Okay, I didn't know if you knew that.
That's what's hot about her. She's a screwed up stripper.
Which one was that? With the short hair?
Yeah, the short red hair who sings decent karaoke.
Yeah, she looks like a dirty girl.
She looks like a dirty... She had a kid. She's like 20 years old. She has a kid.
She was the typical stripper.
Yeah, she's a dirty, filthy girl, and I love it.
Kids in a tub in a motel somewhere. She's
Nikki McKibben. What else you want to tell me?
Also, the DVD that's coming out at the middle of this month, I saw a clip of it off of Entertainment Tonight, and they're all watched in their cars, and you know the one Idol contestant that you had in there that you tried to pay $2,000 to
get. This kid's really in bad shape, isn't he?
Brian?
I got to... He's a master of, like, unimportant stuff.
And he's a wheelchair, too?
He's a messed up kid, but I could get... I'm telling you, he wants to get laid.
And they're spraying each other with hoses.
Okay.
So if the camera gets in the right spot, you'll get to see what she wouldn't show you for the $2,000.
Let me ask you something.
He thinks he's on your level. He's telling you you could catch a peek at this girl. He doesn't have to wait for TV to get a peek.
Yeah. I'm going to have to send this kid to the bunny ranch.
No, send him to the green room at the Labor Day telethon. That's where all the chicks hang out.
Right.
Get a sniff of Charo.
Hey, didn't I send you some money?
Yeah, I got one of the checks already.
How much should I send you?
You sent me a total of $1,000.
Yeah. What'd you do with the money?
Really?
I deposited the one check already, and it's going to be to pay some bills.
All right. I'm gonna send you $500 more, but I want you to spend it on something stupid, like something frivolous, because I feel awful for you.
Buy yourself a stepladder or something. Go nuts.
Yeah. You want $500?
Yeah.
Tell me what you're going to spend it on, and I'll send you $500.
A DVD player.
How about a Louis Vuitton bag on eBay?
How about a Nick DiPaolo t-shirt?
Why don't you go to a strip club with the
$500? I could probably do that, maybe.
Does he have somebody who would take him to a strip
club?
Yeah,
that's what I was going to ask.
You know someone who will take you to a strip club?
Yeah.
What, you got a dude that hangs around with you?
Yeah, I have two friends that...
Normal size?
Yeah.
You got to get some midget friends. Because you know what it is? They make you look bad, those guys. You got to wheel yourself down to like a... Where the hell could this guy get chicks? I said the burn victims unit, but...
Where does he live? Is he in New York?
Where do you live?
In the San Francisco Bay Area.
Oh, gee.
Maybe I'll have this guy down to the Bon Jovi Bukkake party.
Yes,
of course.
There you go.
Then you could make sure things happen right for
him. Do they have ramps?
You know, I don't know. You know what? There's a guy who's suing one of the strip clubs because it wasn't handicap friendly. I swear to God, I got an article on it.
Really?
Yeah, I was going to read it to you yesterday, as a matter of fact. some strip club didn't have ramps.
He's got a point.
Yeah, but man, you look like a real douche. You know, suing over ramps for a strip club.
But anybody needs a lap dance. Come on.
Quadriplegic sues strip club over wheelchair access for lap dances. Edward Law sued the Wildside Adult Sports Cabaret. I like that. Wildside Adult Sports Cabaret last month after visiting the West Palm Beach Club in May and June. The lap dance room is only accessible by a short flight of stairs, according to the suit. It also alleges that the counter around the stage where strippers dance is too high, making it difficult for Law to see the stage and set down his drinks.
See?
This guy, this is an industry that is high profit and knows about ADA and is ignoring it. Attorney Anthony Brady Jr. told South. See, if some dude came.
ADA?
Yeah. I guess it's muscular dystrophy. I see. Americans with Disabilities Act.
Oh.
Yeah, you have to have a ramp to a DJ's booth in regular nightclubs. I know that's a.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Well.
You can make a request. Yeah, can I hear it sitting on the dock of the bay?
Law also sued another West Palm Beach strip club, the Landing Strip. He charges both clubs with violating ADA standards for bathrooms and parking spaces.
The guy's a quad.
There's no specified amount of money in attorney's fees.
How does he set his drink down anyway? He's a quad.
I was going to say, did you put a double sawbuck in his mouth and go, hey, come on over, honey?
I'll tell you what. I'm not inviting this guy to scores.
He'll start trouble.
Yeah.
He'll sue.
I'm going to send you $500. Why don't you go to a strip club with it, okay?
All right.
Promise me you'll go to a strip club.
Okay. Have you ever had the WWE's Stephanie McMahon in there?
Oh, boy.
No.
You'd like to probably have her as a guest.
You got posters of her on your wall?
No. But she's a real good-looking woman.
This kid's so horny. I got it.
I'm telling you, he's pent up.
He wants it so bad.
He only heterosexual in San Francisco.
Yeah. He's got to be able to get laid.
And he's disabled.
All right, you won $500. Yeah, the only heterosexual in San Francisco is a disabled man.
Damn it.
You won $500 courtesy of the hot new movie, Rules of Attraction.
Thank you.
Starring James Vanderbeek, Shannon Sossamon, and Jessica Biel in theaters everywhere October 11th. All right, brother. Hold on.
He ain't heavy. He's your brother.
I'm trying to help this guy. He's in worse shape than me.
It's a tough city to be in a wheelchair, too.
If I was him,
very hilly.
Yeah.
If I was him, I'd have posters on my walls of chicks that look like Janet Reno. Start conditioning myself to go for a different kind of girl.
No, the kid's watching every hot chick on television.
I know.
Healthy guys can't get these chicks.
I wonder if that guy wants a strap on used on him, because I got a porno star that's willing to do it.
Well, there's you. And he's a virgin, isn't he?
Yeah, it doesn't matter where they stay. San Francisco, that was a good point.
Eric the Midget. Who calls me all the time. He's in a wheelchair. He's a big mess. Go ahead, Eric.
Hi, Stephanie.
Hi, Eric.
I watch the WWE all the time. I like SmackDown probably the best, better than Raw.
Thank you very much.
I don't mean to bring up your personal history, Eric, but Eric is a midget in a wheelchair. He's got Britney Spears posters hanging up in his room. He's got Stephanie McMahon fixation. Let me say something. You're never going to get laid this way. When girls come up to your room and see Britney Spears posters and wrestlers.
There's nothing wrong with wrestlers.
Yeah, I mean, you've got to go after. I told him to go to like a burn center and pick up chicks.
That's nice.
Yeah, well, he wants to get laid, the kid. But I'm saying.
He should date somebody, too.
Yeah, he should say. Well, he doesn't want to.
I think he wants a relationship. Yeah. I mean, he's a little above.
Yeah.
So, do you want to just say hi, Eric, or do you have a question for me?
Well, I have a question. One thing I was thinking that WWF or WWE should try to do is maybe to improve attendance, maybe make each of the shows kind of a huge party atmosphere by like having a band before and after each show.
Is that your thought?
What's the matter with you?
First of all,
I detect you're putting on your sexy voice for Stephanie. Stephanie, he doesn't have a chance with you. You're very much committed to Triple H.
Well, he hasn't asked.
Yeah, well, trust me.
Talking about bands.
Yeah. Well, you do love Stephanie McMahon, right?
Yeah, I'm a fan.
Have you fantasized about her?
No, not that.
No.
Tell the truth.
All right, I'm offended.
You've never pleasured yourself thinking about her?
Well, I don't know if I really want to admit that or not.
Oh, you have to admit.
She's offended.
I'm offended that you, if you haven't.
Dude, you whacked it a few times to Stephanie.
Maybe.
All right. That's what I wanted to know. Well, I guess the big thing that you should order, Eric, the midget, is pay-per-view event No Mercy this Sunday at 8. Are you in it, Stephanie?
I probably will be.
What do? You walk out in a sexy outfit?
Well, pretty much in a business suit, because now my character's changed. Now I've taken over SmackDown. I'm the general manager, and I'm sort of at war with Eric Bischoff, who's the general manager of Raw.
Oh, you know, Artie does an Eric Bischoff impression. Go ahead, Eric. I mean, Artie.
By the power vested in me by the state of the WWF, I pronounce you gay wrestling.
It's a good impression.
That's it.
That's not Eric Bischoff? Is that Rico?
If I wasn't, no, that was Eric Bischoff.
That's Eric Bischoff.
Yes. Yeah.
And watch the season premiere of Tough Enough 3 tonight at 10 o'clock at MTV. So when you and...
Eric,
go back to staring at the posters. Let's go to Eric the Midget, Eric.
Hello.
Hey, Eric.
For starters, I would prefer to be referred to as a little person, not a midget.
Yes, why would you call him such a derogatory...
Well, because it's not funny to say Eric the Little Person. I'm a comedian. I make people laugh for a living.
You can't say Eric the Dwarf?
He's not a dwarf. He's a midget.
He's not a midget. There's no such thing.
Yeah. Hey, this little peckerhead, all I've done is give him money and try to help him.
You've given him about $1,500.
Yeah, and he sent me the nastiest goddamn email.
Really? What did it say?
Where is that thing? We got that? Hey, Eric, what's your problem?
Well, it's the fact that last week when I called in to talk to Stephanie, you kind of started making light of the whole situation, and all I wanted to do was just talk to her because, you know, I'm a fan of the WWE, and I had hoped to be able to, you know, have a little chat with her.
Well, you got to talk to her.
I let you talk to her, I gave you money, and then you stabbed me in the friggin' back with an email that was so angry and hurtful.
You can't trust the little people.
I don't. This is turning me off to all little people. I'm going to try not to be prejudiced against little people based on your letter. But you think you ever would have gotten a shot at speaking to Stephanie McMahon if it wasn't for my help?
Yeah, who else has gotten you close to her?
Well, no one, but what frustrated me was that I've been wanting to talk to anyone from the WWE for quite a while now, and I got my first chance at it, and then you go making fun of me on the air while I'm trying to talk to her.
Yeah, but my point is, at least I got you to talk to her. Yeah, I might become a dwarfist if there is such a thing.
Uh-huh.
I know there's a racist. I'm not that. I am a dwarfist. Because, you know, I gave this kid such love and attention. Try to get him laid.
You never give the dwarf enough.
Yeah, and it's just like, you know, the guy just peed all over me. And this, I got the email. You want to hear it?
Yeah.
Listen to this guy. Hello, Stern. This is Eric again. I wanted to write you because I'm tired of being the butt of your jokes. First off, I'm sick of you calling me a midget. I'm not a midget or a dwarf.
Oh,
I'm
you're
a
not even a dwarf.
No, I'm a little person. And only a little person. Whenever you or your staff refers to me as a midget, that's the same as African-Americans hating the N-word. To me, those two words show a lack of damn respect to people like me. Also, I'm not one of your retard, stupid-ass, pathetic, whack-pack freaks. I have more brains than any of your whack-pack retards. You and your staff members all put together don't have my brains.
Ooh.
I graduated near the top of my class in high school. And what could be said of all of you? I don't mean that I graduated near the top of the class of special ed kids. I mean the whole goddamn senior class of 1994. In fact, I challenge every one of you to team up against me in a trivia contest. I got to say, first of all, he spells dwarf, D-O-R-W-F.
Oh, my.
I tried to spell check it, and the computer didn't even catch.
Yeah, the computer doesn't even know what you're up to.
You're not. I don't believe your claim that you were the smartest guy in your high school. I don't believe it for a minute.
Where's this high school?
I could point out 20 typos and grammatical errors in this letter alone.
And he's not that bright.
I'm reading this thing. I go, that little midget, he's sitting there telling me I'm a dick and I gave him money and he got typos. He's telling me he's smarter than me.
What's up with that, Eric?
What school did you go to?
John Sweat.
John Sweat.
That's a special ed school.
No, it's not.
All right.
How do you know? You're all the way in New York. It's in Crockett, California.
Oh, that explains it.
Last Thursday when I talked to Stephanie McMahon, it pissed me off when you first asked me if I fantasized about her, and then you cut me off by hanging up on me.
All right, so what was it you wanted to say?
Well, I got to ask one question, and then the other thing I was going to say was the fact that one of my cousins kind of knows one of her WWE wrestlers.
Oh, that's fascinating.
No wonder I cut you off. You're boring everybody. I give you an opportunity to talk to a chick, and you're like, oh, my cousin knows one of the wrestlers.
Yeah.
My cousin knows the guy that's holding the championship title.
And what is she going to do with that information?
Oh,
exactly. Dude, I give you a shot at talking to a chick that you dig, and right away you're playing Jewish geography with her. I know a cousin of someone who is in the WWF. I can't waste my audience's time with that. So I try to treat the guy nicely. I put him on for a second or two.
Yeah, we keep you from being boring. And
oh, you should see.
I appreciate that.
See how angry this whole thing is.
What else does he say?
Oh, he goes, what is it that every person that you have on your show, when they want to talk, you have to talk about sex? Who the hell do you think you are, Dr. Ruth? To me, I had no problems with you when you were giving me the total $1,500 that you gave me. But why did you have to make me look like an ass on your show to get that money? Giving that money was the only nice thing you did when I called. You are a brainless jackass. If you have a problem with anything I've said, you know my number. Just call. Here it is in case your dumbass forgets it. And I'm not a pathetic disabled mess that needs you to set me up with some legless, toothless woman.
That's another thing. When I was talking to Stephanie, you called me a mess on the air.
You know what, Eric? You should send back the money.
Yeah. Send me back the $1,500 if I'm such a dickhead.
I can't do it. Deposited it. Sent some of it for my bills.
Well, still, pay us back.
Don't see anybody
don't
else.
Take our dirty money.
Yeah, I don't see anybody else doing anything for you. I ain't saying I'm perfect.
And why do you call?
And what's wrong with legless, toothless women?
It's not my type. I'm not against amputees, but the toothless part, that goes a little
too far. You know, all I've ever
said. They could have teeth out.
All I ever said to this guy, seriously, is look, man, if you want to get girls, stop hanging posters in your room of Britney Spears and Kelly Clarkson and the WWF wrestlers.
You try to give them some good advice.
Because when chicks come up to your room and they see that, they're going to be turned off. They're going to think you're a loser. I said, and secondly, maybe you set your sights a little high. You're not going to get Kelly Clarkson from American Idol. You're going to have to, you know.
What, do you think after you told Stephanie McMahon you knew somebody who knew a wrestler, she's going to have lunch with you?
Yeah, that's what he thinks. So I'm trying to be realistic for the guy and say, listen, I think I can get you laid, but you're going to have to maybe take a burn victim or something.
She could have teeth.
Well, if I've done anything wrong is I wanted you to get laid.
And we were trying to have some fun.
Well, stop it.
Also, another thing that you've never given me the opportunity to say is I have a feeling that I am going to get the chance to at least meet Kelly and the rest of them, because I have, over the last few years, been fairly successful in meeting famous people.
You know how?
I know how. He goes there in the wheelchair.
And they bump him up because, you know, you can't say no to a person in a wheelchair.
I say no. I have that a lot. When I used to do the book signings, a lot of wheelchair dudes would come in and go, they'd get bumped right up to the front line. I said, nope. Gotta wait.
Go to the back.
Go right to the back.
I've met Sarah Lipinski twice and Leanne Rimes once, plus a bunch of A's and Giants players.
What do you do? What do you do? You wheel in and then you go, I demand to see some celebrity?
No.
You wheel right to the door?
When I met Leanne, I was in the front row of the concert.
What's so great about you were in the front row of the concert and what happened?
Well, one of the staff members, I don't know if he worked for the venue or if he worked for her, you know, traveling group or what, but he walked in front of us a couple of times and he
came over to me and asked me if I wanted to go backstage and meet her before the concert when there was a big...
Yeah.
Why you?
Why do you think she chose you? Because you're in a wheelchair. Photo op. She releases that to the newspaper.
I don't think there was even anyone taking any photos.
Oh, come on.
Sure.
Big deal.
What makes you think you're so special?
You think you're so special because you met Leanne Rimes? Hey, man, I almost kissed Pam Anderson.
You did kiss her.
That's right.
How can you say that?
I showered with Carmen Electra. What do you think of that?
Oh.
Uh-huh. That shut you up.
And
now, what's your big deal with meeting celebrities anyway? You got to meet a regular girl that's going to do things to you.
Oh.
She's going to take your little midget ass and rock your world.
And the reason why I'm so into sports is I used to play wheelchair sports.
Give that up.
He did.
Wheelchair sports.
He was
sport.
Used to.
I was in soccer, baseball, and bowling.
Oh.
Hey, listen, I like you. And I don't care how much crap you give me. I'm going to get you laid.
You know, next week, I think...
If I get you a girl, can you do it? Can you physically get it going?
Yeah, I've been putting up for a while. I have hernia surgery scheduled.
Hernia surgery?
Uh-huh.
Where's your hernia?
How do you get a hernia? You're not lifting anything heavy.
My disability, which is a disability that weakens the tissues and the stomach lining of the...
Can you perform or not?
Huh?
Can you perform or not?
Yeah.
All right, that's all I need to know.
But you got to wait till after surgery is what he's saying.
No.
That's what he's saying.
The recovery time is 4 weeks. I read on the internet earlier.
Yeah, but he hasn't had the surgery yet. He could do it.
Oh, when is the surgery?
Probably the 6th of November.
So you got a couple of weeks, Howard.
What do? You sit home all day?
Pretty much.
Yeah, you got to get outside. I sent the money so we could get outside.
He hasn't gone anywhere.
Figured you'd at least go to the bank and deposit it.
Did you pay for front seat tickets at that concert, or did they just wheel you up to the front?
They wheel them up to the front. I know it.
No, I got front row.
From what? Make a wish?
No.
Leanne Rimes, man. Now I'll tell you what. She looks good. She lost a whole bunch of that baby fat.
Somebody must have threatened her with jail.
You're not kidding. She pulled a Lizzie Grubman. She looks good.
She's got a funny face.
Yeah. Yeah. No, she's good.
She's married.
Is that what stopped you?
Well, she wasn't back then. I was...
So why didn't you make a move?
You know how, Chot. Well, you put me down.
I didn't.
All right, don't send me nasty emails anymore.
I didn't do anything
because
she was under
18,
so...
You know what? You should have gone for it.
She's under 18 and you're under 4 feet, so...
Yeah. This guy's a regular sawed-off... Dunkelman on. That was
it. Maybe Simon will come back. We'll call
maybe him. Simon.
Hey, you were talking about the new judge. I saw earlier on an entertainment show that she is a Hispanic woman named Angela Martinez.
Yeah. She works on one of the black stations here in New York.
Yeah.
Mm. All right. Be mad at God, not me.
All right.
Thank you. Oh, he sent me this nasty email. I was all pissed.
Yeah.
I'm like, man, that little sucker. I was so good to him.
Try to help a dude, and what happened?
You can't win with these people. You can't win.
What do you mean, these people?
These little people. I mean it. Eric the Midget, you're on the air. Eric?
Hey, Howard.
Hey.
How are you?
Okay.
I'm calling because I went to the American Idol concert on Saturday.
Oh, this is Eric the Midget.
Yeah, the guy who loves Kelly.
Yeah, you're in love with Kelly.
Yeah.
From American Idol.
Yep.
I told him he should set his sights lower, but he gets mad at me when I say that.
From his wheelchair. Where did you get? Right up front?
Yeah, he's got the wheelchair and he's a midget, right away he can get up front.
I got pretty close. It was about 12 rows back.
Ooh, 12 rows?
You know, you should be into Condoleezza Rice. You can maybe get her.
She's bangable.
Then Condoleezza will lead you.
Come on. Here, I got a good song for you. Amazing I can get any ratings with the equipment I have. It's laughable.
It's a nightmare.
I never heard of a skipping CD.
Don't.
I heard of records.
The only people, they made the CD to avoid this.
That's why it was invented. All right, I'm not going to get angry. I'm in anger management. We're working on it. Yeah, because I have a lot of anger inside me.
Look at you.
See, I'm just laughing it off.
Aware of the buttocks.
That's all. Aware of the buttocks.
Tense them. Inhale and hold the breath while tense. Keep tensing the buttocks. When I say to release.
Okay.
Let the tension in your buttocks and your inhalation also be suddenly released. Release.
I did it. It works.
You let the tension away in your buttocks?
My buttocks.
That guy is relaxing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He irritates me.
Allow the mind to rest.
Got it.
Let the mind sink into a still deeper state of rest and peace. If any thoughts come that try and pull you from the here and now, do not get involved with them.
Involved.
Watch them come and watch them go.
Do not get involved.
How come you can't pronounce
a V?
With them.
How hard is it to pronounce a V?
If this guy's the wisest guy on earth, say V.
Involved. My thoughts are that you sound very involved.
There's no V in that culture.
Yeah, they don't have a V.
You're going to have the most.
All right, enough with him.
With the buttocks.
Yeah, so what? How was the show?
It was good.
Hey, you're a pretty good reviewer.
You sound all excited about it.
Hello?
I'm still here.
Did you get to touch her?
No, didn't get to meet her at all.
Did you see her on stage?
Yeah.
Did you get a little boner?
No.
What was the best song?
Probably the one single she's got, Before Your Love.
Before Your Love.
You're talking about the one that she does when she goes, I can't believe this is happening to me in a moment like this.
No, that's the other one.
Oh.
I didn't know she had another.
Who knew?
She didn't sing that one.
Where's my American Idol album?
She didn't even sing A Moment Like This. Well, that's a riff.
She's sick of it. She wants to be treated more than a one-hit wonder.
That's right. She wants to sing the new stuff.
What was she wearing, Eric?
Oh, there were like 5 or 6 costume changes for all of them.
Mm-hmm. Did Justin change his costume?
Yeah, he changed a couple of times.
Wow.
They did. The way it worked was EJ Day went first. And then...
Oh, boy.
Well, he's really into it. E.J. Day went first. The way it works.
E.J. Day.
We have that song?
Which one?
Kelly.
A Moment Like This?
No, she has a new one, according to Eric. What's the new one called again?
Before Your Love.
See, they didn't put it on the American Idol album. Yeah. Oh, there it is. Oh. Bonus tracks, 15, Before Your Love.
Oh, it's a bonus.
There you go. This is for you, Eric. Little Kelly Clarkson.
We'll bring you back.
Well, looks like we're there. Here we go. Very exciting.
What's the deal with the money?
Oh, dear.
We cannot win. I can't even play a record. Is that it, Eric?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I wonder how I ever made it through the
day. Beautiful.
How could I settle for the world and shades of gray?
Was she staring at you when she sang?
No, each of them walked to each side of the stage during their performances.
She didn't notice you?
No.
How do you miss a midget?
12 rows back. I can't believe they wouldn't put him right up front.
Yeah.
I had to sit where the wheelchair setup was done.
Oh.
Sounds like, so you got lost in a sea of wheelchairs. She sounds like she has a big heart. I bet she'd accept your wheelchair.
Yes.
Yeah.
What did those other losers think?
One thing good about a wheelchair, if there's anything good about it, it's a drag to be in one, but I know when I used to do my book signings and stuff, anyone in a wheelchair came right up to the front
right
of the line.
Yeah, right up to the front. And a lot of people, amusement parks.
But a lot of people came up to me and said, the guy's sitting down. He can wait online. We're standing. I said, hey, what do you want from me? That's the way it goes. A guy in a wheelchair, you're not going to tell him to stop.
I think they want to hurry up and get him out of the way.
Should I have just told those people to go to the back of the line?
That's right. Wait your turn.
And that's a scam that works.
I'm treating you like everybody else.
If you just pretend to be in a wheelchair, not a lot of people check you. You know?
That's true. She's got a big lower half, doesn't she, Eric?
Never really noticed.
She's perfect, isn't she?
Yeah, yes.
Yes, she's
perfect. Yes, she is, Robin. You ain't gonna get laid at those concerts.
She's perfectly oblivious to you, isn't she?
Yeah, she's ignoring you, dude.
The only new song that any of them sang was the one that she sang. All the other songs were hits from, from the 80s and before.
I know. When those kids start doing those songs, they really ruin them.
Did you enjoy the concert?
Yeah.
Are you kidding? Of course. What'd you pay for that?
Let's see. Both tickets came to over 100.
Wow. What a racket.
I wonder what the kids are making.
What a racket. The kids are making nothing.
That's what I'm thinking, that they're just along for the ride and somebody.
That's with all the, processing fees from the...
I remember when the kids come out and sing these songs and it's like up with people.
Yeah.
But they're making a ton of money. And ladies and gentlemen, now, a little respect from Miss Kelly Clarkson.
What you want, baby, I got it. What you need,
about ripping the soul out of it.
All I'm asking is for the respect to get home, hey, baby.
It's sad to get unbelievably faggy here at WFRN is going to gay it up, dear.
Ladies and gentlemen, the moment you've been... Do they have an announcer that announced each kid, Eric?
No, they show, at the beginning, they show Randy Jackson on video, introducing the show. And then after each of them is done performing solo, they introduce the next one.
Oh, they introduce.
Hi,
do they sing together?
Yeah, they...
Oh, that's great.
They did all 10 of them sang separately to begin with.
Hi, I'm Nicky McGibbon, and now here's Justin Guarini.
And that's the exact order. They went from the...
Were you
tenth,
there?
From the 10th person to the first.
Just when you thought it couldn't get gayer, we're coming at you with this.
With Justin Guarini.
Say
Oh, so they go in the order by which they lost on the contest. Oh, that's good. Yeah, that's only fair.
The Fagometer hits red.
Wait a second. Coming up on the Fagometer at a big 10.
You can faggot on it.
Yeah, Fagometer.
Oh, my gracious. I feel like I'm making out with a man.
The needle is tending.
On an airplane. Hello,
and do all the kids work it like they're smiling, like professional singers?
Yeah.
Have they gotten any better?
No. Oh, sorry, Eric.
Quite a bit better.
You think?
Was Nikki McGibbon there?
Yeah, she was there. Her mom was actually there, too.
Was the kid there?
I don't know.
Is Nikki hot?
She's pretty cute.
Who's your favorite? Tamira?
No, it's Kelly and Nikki.
Go, Nikki!
Yeah.
Do you dance in your seat?
Come on, Nikki.
No.
Nikki, come on.
I'm just wondering what he does. I mean, the music.
Well, for start.
Eric, here's a little Nikki McGibbon for you.
Come on.
She's the rock and roll kid.
Yeah. Time to hard rock. All you hobos, hard rock time. I'm K-R-S.
W-H-O-M-O.
W-F-A-T.
Didn't I make you feel like you were the only man?
I like penis. 68 degrees and I'm a big bag. Here I come.
You got one of those laser lights, Eric?
Yeah.
Because you can, like, attach it to your wheelchair.
Yeah, you got to do something to distinguish yourself if they're just going to shove you in with a bunch of wheelchairs.
Eric, do you sing along with the kids?
No.
Come on.
Do you scream when Kelly comes out?
No.
Do you applaud?
Yeah, I applauded.
What, is it mostly chicks in the audience?
Yeah, but I know there's quite a few guys.
Gay guys, right?
Possibly, but, you know, with Nikki and Kelly and... Yeah, the other girls, I'm sure there were quite a bit of straight guys, too.
And who goes with you to this?
Well, it was my mom and I.
Oh, boy, you can't get laid with your mom, man.
Dragged around to this concert.
Okay, Red's big fairy contest heats up.
Do you tell your mom to, like, act like she's just your friend? Like, hey, Mom, act like you're a hot chick who's into me. Do me a favor.
Act like my date.
You ever start making out with your mom to show chicks you can get girls?
No.
Mom, I know this is disgusting, but I need you to tongue me.
Get on my lap.
These girls will think I'm with my mom. I'll never get laid.
Who's your mom like best?
Nikki? Nikki McGibbon?
No, I just thought RJ was cute.
RJ.
Did you ever say to one of your friends, does this Kelly Clarkson shirt make me look gay?
Did you wear your Kelly Clarkson shirt?
I don't have one.
Good, thank God.
Did you buy anything? Did they have a lot of merchandise?
Yeah, they had quite a bit.
What'd you buy?
A poster and a program.
A poster of?
A program?
The poster has all 10 of them on it.
Where'd you hang that? I hope in a big homo room.
I don't have it up. No wall space.
No wall space?
What is on the wall now?
Well, one wall is wallpapered, and then the other has pictures on them.
Of what?
Well, there's...
Guy sacks?
I don't want to take out my guy sack pictures. So
oh, dear. No, really. It wasn't...
I want to put my poster of American Idol right next to the picture of the guy.
Oh, dear. Just ignore these guys.
This is good for him. You got to tease a kid. You got to tease a kid out of homo.
Yeah, that's how I became a man.
Of course. What happened?
I used to have pictures of guy sacks on my wall. I didn't know it was wrong.
Eric, goddammit, take that picture of the guy's sack down. I've told you 1,000 times.
Oh, really? What kind of poster did you get?
Well, I got sports and wrestling.
wrestling.
No, dudes.
This guy sucks.
You got a lot of dudes on your wall, dude.
You need some vagina up there.
Yeah. We know Pam Anderson or Carmen Electra?
No.
Do you know who they are?
Yeah.
Yeah, dude.
You're aware of them, okay.
Dude, all I'm telling you is I'm trying to help you. You hang up that American Idol poster, you're never going to get laid in this century. Because I know you want to get laid, right?
Yeah.
All right, well. Girls are going to think you're not, but they're going to think you're a super fag.
It's super fag.
You got to hang up money.
Yeah, forget the rest.
How you think an ugly guy like me gets laid?
We'll pay for your room with hundreds.
Artie had to pay up $500 in Vegas to get laid.
Exactly.
We're real
Artie
men.
Artie knows how to get a woman.
Artie ain't with no sack.
Yeah. You don't see me with no...
Those wrestling posters, sometimes out of the tights, you can see some sack and package.
Dude, you got man sack hanging on your wall.
Yeah. What are you doing?
Coming at you, Nikki McGibbon.
Coming up next, a picture of a guy's sack.
Uh-oh.
Come on.
Sing it. You know she's going to be stripping in a month.
Oh, I hope
already
so.
Already see the pole.
Hey, now.
She wear hot little outfits, Eric?
Yeah.
But you like to bang a piece of that, huh?
I don't know.
You probably couldn't even handle that.
These bitches never give any to midgets.
Yes, bastard.
Yeah, old Vern Troyer, he's in rehab again.
Yeah, Vern Troyer's in rehab, did you hear?
No.
Yeah. Vinny me.
When are you guys headed back to Vegas?
I don't know. I'm so lazy I won't even look at the calendar.
Is it, we're not planning the date yet?
If somebody plans it, I'll go. Why should I have to do everything?
You know what? You can't go to Vegas till I retract that tipping story.
Yeah, right. Yeah. That's right.
No, you got to go and show them you're a big-hearted guy.
Hey, Eric. I got some A.J. Gill for you.
Oh. A.J. Gill.
Let's get down with A.J. Ma chérie amour.
He's singing to you. Maybe Kelly did it for you.
Just when you felt heterosexual.
That's a dude.
Look at dude show.
I gotta go watch some porno.
That's why that show was wrong.
I know. Was this dude there?
Yeah.
AJ?
Yeah,
what'd you do when he was on?
I just watched.
I hope you, like, turned your head.
Yeah, what? I mean, how could you go to this person?
Did he do my Sharia more?
Yeah.
My Sharia more.
I think Jim was the one that introduced him, and he introduced him as being the next big Latin sensation.
Oh, sure.
Sure he is.
I'm like thinking, I didn't even realize he was Latin.
So when you went home, did you, like, pleasure yourself after the concert?
No.
Liar.
Well, no, I didn't.
What, did you do it during?
Which idol... Which idol member did you do it to? Come on, be honest with me. Don't be embarrassed.
Not.
Oh, you're lying.
No.
You don't tell me you didn't think about Kelly? You and Kelly on a date?
Or Nikki? No. You and Kelly and Nikki?
You, Kelly and Nikki in a midget three-way?
Kelly.
Do you think he shrinks the women down to size, or would he like a full-size woman? Oh. In his mind.
Yeah, that's an interesting question. Were you thinking about Justin Guarini?
Oh, no way.
All right.
Sitting there looking at a wrestling picture.
Don't hang his picture on your wall.
Well, who is your favorite wrestler? Wrestling's over, isn't it?
So who you got hanging on your wall?
Austin, Sting, and Goldberg.
Wow.
No Eric Bischoff?
Like a big, beefy man, do you?
Eric, it's me!
It's Eric Bischoff!
Boy, are you gay!
Not even.
I saw you at the American Idol concert! How's that program doing? I saw you buying a program at the American Idol concert! Wow, that's faggy!
Like, when you get a program...
What do you do with it?
Do you have to go up and buy it? Like, do you have to go to a counter?
Yeah.
So everyone can see you buying it?
I'd like your American Idol program.
How much did that cost you? How much did it cost?
Too much.
Does one of those come with a tutu?
What'd you do with the program? You still got it?
Yeah.
You didn't even get it signed by anybody.
No,
in a wheelchair, you should be able to work that.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Damn, I wish I knew you were going to that. I could have got you a backstage pass.
Yeah.
You don't like that other cute girl in the contest?
What one's that?
Well, there's a...
Ryan Seacrest.
Right.
The Ryan Starr.
Ooh. Ooh, yeah, she was hot.
That's cute.
Bet you blew your load when you saw her.
No.
I know I did.
Well, enjoy the program. Enjoy the concert. Hey, you know what? We're making fun of you, but I watch the
show.
Hey,
yeah, you know, somebody's got to be watching.
That's right.
American
Idol. I would have gone with you.
Last week, I was trying to get through to the show because the week before was when I had the hernia surgery done.
Oh, you did have your surgery.
Yeah.
Well, don't bring everyone down with that.
I had just spent 3 nights.
How do you have a hernia? You're not lifting anything.
I know, but my disability weakens the cartilage.
His disability, man. This guy's got problems. I always give you money. Did you spend it all?
Pretty much.
On programs?
No.
You want 500?
Yes, please.
Oh.
All right. I'm giving you 500 because you kill me.
He doesn't even like us. He just calls for the money.
I don't care. He's a midget in a wheelchair. He can't get laid. I'm giving it to him. I don't care.
Give him 500, but don't buy a poster with it.
If I give you 500, what are you going to get? If you get more of that homo material.
Buy some more American Idol tickets.
Get a Playboy.
Don't waste my money on that kind of crap.
I'm not.
What is your life expectancy?
Well, my life expectancy, according to the doctors when I was a kid, was teens.
Oh, so you've outlived them.
Oh, yeah.
Way to go.
I've been proving the doctors wrong pretty much my whole life.
Yeah, they all said you were straight.
I am Artie.
He's straight, Artie.
I know.
I'm
breaking his chops. You gotta, you know, you do this with
kids. Treat him like one of the guys.
It's good for kids.
Kids? He's how old?
How old are you?
40.
Oh.
No, 27.
Oh, God,
you won $500 courtesy of Acclaim's BMX Triple X, which is a great video game, by the way. Available on all video game systems right now. BMX Triple X is really so dirty, a lot of stores won't sell it. All right, Eric, I got to go.
All right.
Later, brother.
Maybe you should start sending him the video game.
Yeah, something to beat off to. kid's got posters of wrestlers on his wall.
I know.
Yeah. Thank you.
Xin chào tất cả mọi người. Và hôm nay bên em về một chiếc Hyundai Accent, chiếc xe sản xuất 2018 bản 1.4 số tự động. Xe này phiên bản màu đỏ và là bản cao cấp, vì vậy là nó có full option, cửa sổ trời này, tay nắm cửa mạ chrome, tất cả mọi thứ từ ngoại thất đến nội thất là full. Con này báo một mức giá rất là rẻ thôi. Giá này thì cực kỳ là dễ mua luôn. Và bây giờ thì trước khi mà em báo giá thì em sẽ quay tổng thể chiếc xe và xem nó có những cái vấn đề gì. Xe này thì các bạn có thể thấy là đèn rất là đẹp. Thank you.
Thank you.